Now, in this short video, I'm going to show you how Inforiver can deliver on one of the most voted on ideas at ideas.powerbi.com. So this is the feature we're going to talk about, which is to add, expand and collapse buttons for column headers. You can see the number of votes that it has had. And this has been under review for a long period of time, still not being delivered. I'm sure Microsoft will deliver it at some point in time, but you don't have to wait. You can already get this feature using Inforiver. So I'm going over here to my workbook, and for this demonstration, I'm going to use the professional version. This also works in the standard version, although there are a couple of things I'm going to show you that you can't do in the standard version. So I'll just go into full screen mode. Perhaps before I do that, let me show you the standard behavior of the standard matrix. So I add the matrix to the canvas, and I'm going to bring calendar year and month into the columns. And just to make this a little bit more meaningful, I'll bring product category and subcategory into the rows, and I'll just bring the sales amount onto the values. So this is the standard behavior of the matrix visual, and you can expand and collapse at the row level, but there is no such feature on the column level. Now, that doesn't mean that you can't expand and collapse. You can. What you can do is you can come here and you can expand to the next level by right-click expanding, so that will work. But when I did that, notice that it expanded everything. So what it's done is it's expanded all the years and all the months, and so you can see the large number of data points. I don't have the option of just expanding one of the nodes in the hierarchy that I want. I have to expand all of them. And of course, I don't have that user interface with little plus minus buttons. So that's the current standard behavior in the Power BI matrix visual. So maybe what I'll do is I'll keep this layout and I'll just switch over to Inforiver Professional. So I'll just basically replace the visual that was there, which was the matrix, with the new one. And you can see that I've inherited this. It's not a perfect one for one, so I just need to make a few changes. I'll bring the month name over onto the calendar year. And you can see that I do have these expand and collapse options now as a standard part of, in this case, it's Inforiver Professional. Just to show you that it does work under the standard version, I'll switch over to Inforiver Standard. And you can see slightly different behavior because this is using one of the formatting templates which comes standard within Inforiver. And I might just come in here and I'll expand the menu and I'll change these templates and I'll just put it back to the standard grid. And when it's the standard grid, you see it's exactly the same as I had before in Professional. So I will switch back to Professional because I do want to show you that you can also hide columns that you don't want. So it's possible within here, if you want to, is you can come in and I'll just maybe zoom out a little bit, multi-select these columns, holding shift click, and then I can just hide those columns. So in fact, when I hid those columns, it actually doesn't give me a total for 2018 anymore. And that's because I have no totals. I'll just come over here and turn on the total. I want to see the subtotal to the right. So I've hidden the January to December monthly data for 2018, but I've still got the total. And so I can selectively do this if I want. This hiding feature that I'm showing you is only available in Professional and above. This hiding feature is not available in Standard. So just so that you know that. And it's also possible that I could expand, say, this node here. And if I don't want my end users to come in and expand and collapse, I can come in under display hierarchy and I can actually just turn off the hierarchy icons. I'll just set this to none. And so once I turn that off, the ability for a user to come in and expand and collapse has been removed. And I might want to do something like here. I might want to come down and just hide this just so that it looks a little bit more consistent. So lots of flexibility, but that key ideas.powerbi.com, one of the most voted for features is to have those expand collapse icons on the columns, and it's already available in Inforiver custom visual.